Hi, 8th graders. So this is the instructional video for lesson 51, which is Latin and Greek roots, prefixes, suffixes, and everything having to do with parts of speech. So in this unit, we're going to have a little fun. We're going to create our own words using Latin and Greek roots and by adding a suffix, which will tell us the part of speech. So this is kind of a supplement and kind of an overview of everything that we've studied so far this year with our grammar unit, with our word study unit. Anything that has to do with building words, building word meaning, and understand how words are used in a sentence, you're going to finish it up in this particular unit. So how do we create a word? Well, the first thing we want to think about are what the meanings of our Latin and Greek roots are and how we can put them together that to make a word that might make sense. The last thing is, the most important thing is, selecting the suffix that you're going to put at the end of the word so that it will determine its part of speech. So here's an example that I want to share with you and talk about how it came to be. So this word is aqua ignisable. And you'll notice that aqua is the root meaning water. Ignis means to ignite. And the suffix means ible, means able to. So it's really important when you're creating your own fun new words, that you start with the suffix in your definition, because that's how we create a meaningful definition. So aqua ignisable has three parts: water, ignite, able to. Well, if I just said those in that order, water, ignite, able to, that doesn't make any sense. But if I start with the definition of the suffix, the definition is going to start with able to. Well, I am able to what? If I look at my other two parts, I am able to water ignite. Well, that doesn't make sense. Am I able to ignite water? So that makes more sense. Ignite water. So my brand new word, aqua ignisable, which is not a word in the dictionary, you can check it out if you don't believe me, We can say that it means able to ignite water. Or maybe I want to extend it a little bit. Maybe I want to say able to ignite in water. I'm allowed to add those few little words because it's my word, and maybe that's the meaning that I want it to have. Because it ends in the suffix I-B-L-E, that suffix is one of the many suffixes you'll find that are adjective suffixes. So what? It's an adjective. Well, that means when I'm using it in a sentence, I have to use the word aqua ignisable to describe something. So I'm going to do that in the following sentence. So here's my sentence. The underwater welder used an aqua ignisable torch to repair the dam. So it's an adjective, therefore I have to think about, well, what is it describing? Well, the word aqua ignisable is describing the noun torch, because this is a kind of torch that you would need to use underwater. My other clues that let you know it has something to do with being underwater is underwater welder and repairing a dam. So all of those context clues will help you understand that this make-believe word, aqua ignisable, actually makes sense, and that I can use it in a sentence to describe something that you would use underwater. In this case, it is a torch. So for the next couple slides, we're going to look at the Latin and Greek roots and then suffixes. And then you're going to be developing just a couple words from each of the parts, the four parts of speech, the big four: nouns, verbs, adjectives, and adverbs. And I'll talk you through on how I want you to do that. So here are two lists, the most common Latin roots and the most common Greek roots. And you can pick and choose from either list. It doesn't really matter. So I'm just going to look at these lists and I'm going to see something that might be fun to put together. So I'm looking at fract, because it has to do with something that breaks. And I'm going to choose phobia over here in the common Greek roots. Phobia means fear. So I have fractophobia. So right now, I don't know what that part of speech might be. So I have to next go to the list on the next page that has suffixes, and then we'll talk about how I can actually make fractphobia become a word. So here are the lists of the most common parts of speech suffixes. So my noun suffixes, I've given you the common list and what they mean. I've got verb suffixes, I've got adjectives, and then the only suffix for an adverb is the ly. So let's say I want to make fractphobia, I want to turn it into a noun. And let's choose something simple. I'm going to choose ment. Whoops, I'm going to go back and change that color. ment. And I'm going to add that to my word. So I have fractphobia ment. So the definition, the state of, and then I have phobia means fear, fract means break. The state of being afraid of breaks. And that's a noun. And how do I know it's a noun? Because it's in the noun suffix category. And typically I would include the word the state of being afraid of breaks. So if I think about how I would use that in a sentence, we all know poor Mrs. Moulton broke both of her ankles a couple of years ago. So maybe Mrs. Moulton has fractphobia ment or suffers from fractphobia ment because she has broken both of her legs and now she's afraid of breaking more things. So if I want that to be a noun, I'm going to choose one of the noun suffixes. And the definition of the suffix is what I use to start my definition. So that's really important that you do that. So we're going to take this word and we're going to turn it next into a verb, turn it into an adjective, and then turn it into an adverb. Okay, so I took my original crazy word, fractphobia. Remember, fract meaning break and phobia meaning fear. And I wanted to turn it into a verb. So what I did is I chose the verb suffix ate. Because phobia ends in A, I don't have to add another A. I just created that suffix there. So when I'm writing my definition, the definition of the suffix comes first. ATE means to cause or to make. And what am I causing or making? The fear of breaks. So I could use it in a sentence. Breaking both of my ankles caused me to fractphobiate from here on in, especially in the winter. So if you can do it, it's a verb. I wonder what this would look like if it were an adjective. So if I want to make this word and turn it into an adjective, and remember adjectives describe nouns, here are some of the common adjective suffixes, F-U-L, O-U-S, I-O-U-S, I-C, ish, A-L, Y, able, ible. So I'm looking at these and I'm trying to make a word that makes sense. And I think because the word fractphobia ends with an A, I'm going to use able. That way I don't have to add other letters or it won't be weird. Not that this isn't weird, but I'm going to make the word fractphobiable, which means, because able and ible mean able to fear breaks. And I know that's an adjective because it ends in able or ible. So if I wanted to use that in a sentence, I have a fractphobiable concern over my safety when I walk on the ice. So this fear, able to fear breaks, I'm able to do that because I feel fractphobiable. I feel that way. And that means able to fear breaks. So you don't have to keep repeating the same two roots and adding new suffixes. For this project, I want you to just explore. I want you to have fun. I want you to look at the roots, the Latin and Greek roots, and find combinations of roots that you want to put together that might make up some fun new word. And it's really important that you put a suffix that will help you determine the part of speech. So when this is done, you're going to create one noun, one verb, one adjective, and one adverb. And the next slide, I'll show you how I want you to do that. To create your four words, I want you to follow this template, and I've given you an example. So one, to build any word, you're going to start with two or more Latin or Greek roots. I don't care. Find something that's fun to put together. Make sure that you know the meaning of the root as you're developing your new word. So then you're going to write each root in the order that you think it makes sense. Since it's your word, just think about it. Which combination makes sense, sounds better? Be sure to include the meaning of each root. Then number three is probably the most important. You're going to need to select a suffix for the part of speech that you're creating. So if you're creating a verb like I did, then you have to go to the list of verb suffixes. And when you're writing your definition, you're going to number four, write a definition that begins with the suffix definition. Your suffix definition is how you start your dictionary definition. So to give you an example, here's my word, bene judate. Bene means good, jud means to judge, and ate means to cause or to make. So I'm going to start with the definition of ate when I write my dictionary definition. So bene judate means to cause or to make, and then I have bene and judge. If I said judge good, that doesn't sound like it makes any sense. So it sounds better if I say good judgments. So benejudate is something that I can do. It's a verb. I can benejudate when I have to choose between right and wrong. I can make good judgments. So what you guys are going to do for this fun final project, where you're going to be just summing it all up, roots, prefixes, suffixes, parts of speech, everything that we've studied since fall, you're going to create four words. You're going to need to create one noun. Oops, let me change the color. One noun. So look at your noun suffixes. You're going to need to create one verb, one adjective, and one adverb. So you can do these in Pages. You can do these in Google Docs. Google Docs is probably the easiest way to share it back through Google Classroom. So this is just a fun way for us to just take everything we've learned and do something creative with it. If you really want to go the extra mile, maybe think about a dictionary entry where you might draw a picture of what the word looks like, or try using the word in a sentence. Those things will allow you to exceed the standard. But to meet the standard, you need to create these four types of words. You need to create a word and a dictionary definition with its part of speech that makes sense based on the meanings of its roots and suffix. So that's, if you just do what you're seeing here with bene judate and with the definition, that's meeting the standard, because that's pulling it all together. But if you really want to exceed the standard, write it in a sentence, draw a picture, do both, come up with some synonyms and antonyms, you decide. But what I really want you to do is just have some fun, create your own words, and before you hand them in, check them out in the dictionary, make sure they don't already exist. So this is really going to be our last formal practice with our Latin and Greek roots, prefixes, suffixes, and parts of speech. So have a good time.